Alright guys, hey, we are here at the Patio Social Club Cigar Bar and Lounge. And I have with me Mr. Ken Hamlin, guys, out of Houston, Texas. And he is here to announce the new arrival of, you know what it is. And so we're going to put him on. He's going to tell us a little bit about himself and what inspired him to start this cigar line. Black owned, guys, so you got to hear it.
What's going on? First off, let me say whatever. It's good to be back in the A. It's good to be back at a spot. This is another black-owned type of spot, the patio. So to have the arrival in the A and at this type of spot is definitely a great start.
Okay. So what inspired you? Let's step over here. That way we can get the back of the patio right there. There we go, y'all. We are here, right here. The Patio Social Club. All right. So what inspired you to start your own cigar line?
Well, I've been smoking probably about 15 years, and it's sort of grown as the years have gone by, and I went from smoking for like a celebratory type of thing to actually smoking with a purpose and going into the lounges, being a part of that whole environment, going to a lot of the events, IPCPR in Vegas, Big Smoke, those type of things. And then I started going to the Costa Cigar Fest in Dominican Republic, and that sort of opened my eyes to a whole other possibility. I started learning from these guys out there, the factory owners, the growers, and at one point grew my own tobacco in my backyard.
Really?
So that sort of grew into the possibility of actually doing it.
Right.
Talked with a lot of different owners, and they were beyond open to actually be a part of, you know, what I was doing.
Supporting you.
Yeah, so
right.
That made it, man. They saw my, I guess, the steps that I was taking.
Right.
To be a part of something like this. So it became a common thing of us really working together.
Okay, and I like the whole vibe, you know, the whole gentleman, suave, you know what I'm saying, the social atmosphere, the grown.
One thing I like is that it's a whole culture. I mean, the cigar thing is definitely something that, first off, is not a cheap hobby.
No.
So to be a part of it, to be something, be in this, whatever, it's definitely a change from, you know, younger, doing the club thing and that type of stuff,
right,
to being in a lounge and sort of kicking back and enjoying and sort of that whole networking type of thing. So I enjoy that a lot.
Absolutely. I've been watching you a lot when you first started introducing your line, and I said, well, when he comes back to Atlanta, I'm going to definitely jump on and interview him and get his story and see, you know, how we can support you here in Atlanta, because, you know, I'm all about supporting black-owned businesses. You know, I started my own talk show, Bar Talk ATL, for this environment.
I like it.
Just to come out to the social life, the elite clubs and lounges, and interview people like yourself who are doing some great things, making some moves. So I appreciate
it. I appreciate it. I mean, of course, especially in the black community, I mean, we are growing in this industry. We're doing more in this industry. So instead of just being a consumer, being on the other side of it and actually developing cigars and being part of that, I see it so much now that it's a lot of black-owned cigars that I didn't even know about. To go to different spots, I was just in Orlando and met a guy that has his own cigar, has had it for a couple years now. So it started just to grow even more. Now we're able to be a part of it on every side of it.
It's trending.
Definitely. We're going to do more than just trend. We're going to put a foothold on the industry and really be a part of and be respected in the industry.
Absolutely. So if we're a product or if we're an inheritance of our ancestors that are out there picking the tobacco, why not?
Exactly.
Why not benefit from what?
Yeah,
we're taking it back on top.
We have been a part of it for a while, so why not be the head of it as well?
Absolutely,
so,
I mean, I like
can
that.
Do it. And the thing is, whatever, that it just takes certain people to get out and actually take that step. And,
okay.
I just seen that opportunity, and definitely I'm glad to be a part of it.
All right, so what were you doing before cigars?
Well, I played a little bit of football.
Okay.
So, yeah, I've been retired now 10 10 years. I played with Seattle Seahawks and the Dallas Cowboys.
Okay.
So that was one life.
And right.
I still was young to where I got to be able to relax at home a lot and sort
right.
of figure out what I wanted to do next. And I might have other investment type stuff and businesses, but this is something I can actually be hands-on with. Actually take with me when I travel and go different places.
Absolutely. And it's a great thing to do something that you love.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Have fun with it, meet people, socialize, network on top of that. And
it's not work for that when you actually enjoy it.
That's right. And it's a beautiful thing. But I am not a smoker. But you know, I'll meet a guy and he'll be like, first thing I say, do you smoke cigars? Because every now and then I will smoke a cigar. Especially when I'm on vacation. Or especially when I feel sexy. I feel sexy tonight, so I'm gonna gonna smoke me a cigar. I'm gonna smoke me an arrival. Is that the name of this? The arrival has
you have
arrived.
We have arrived. Exactly. And this is the Atlanta arrival. We are in the building. Is making stops.
Okay.
This is definitely for the long haul, not for a short stint. So we will be making our way and making an impact.
All right, y'all stay tuned. I see this thing getting really, really big. I see a lot of attention being drawn, and you're doing a great job with your promotion.
Yeah, I mean, the best
you make it look
that,
so sexy, and it makes people want to be involved with whatever it is that you're doing.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it. The vibe has always been good. Yeah. Every spot that I've gone to, they show love, and
yeah.
You know, we want to keep that going.
All right, we're doing the 60 tonight. We got our arrivals right now. And I want to thank you again for coming on to Bar Talk ATL, interviewing with your host, Lady M, aka Marcella Phillips. So thank you so much. We're about to go in here and I'm going to get some Henny with this.
Uh-oh. I don't know. I never know.
The night starts.
Oh, I may do a little crown peach.
My top
crown
down is not red.
I don't know. It's gonna be brown, but here we are at the patio, guys. So you can find the cigars here in Cigar City and all throughout Atlanta coming.
So. Soon. Definitely soon.
And of course in Houston, right?
Of course, Houston, Dallas, Austin, San Antonio, we are definitely there. So look it out. And then of course I'm online, the Arrival Cigars on Instagram. Okay. Buck Ken Hamlin is my tag on Instagram. And arrivalcigars.com.
All right, arrivalcigars.com, y'all. Peace and love.
Peace
and
out.
We're out. It's a wrap.